This Medical Minute, sponsored by Avera.
Each week, new questions emerge as changes develop in COVID-19 vaccinations and new strains are detected in South Dakota. I talked with Avera Medical Group's Dr. Kevin Post in this question and answer series. He answers the question about the new at-home antibody testing.
Yeah, the at-home antibody test is something we're watching closely. I did touch base with our specialists in lab, our pathologists as well, and they are still looking at the specifics of the accuracy of this test. I think what's important is that if you do have positive antibody testing, just don't let it be a false reassurance that you cannot have a reinfection, and it still underscores the point that it's really important to still get vaccinated to help boost some baseline immunity you may have to hopefully position yourself best to fight off infection or passing it, possible COVID infection on to others.
Those 80 plus certainly have been hit the hardest with the coronavirus. About 5,200 positive cases and about 1,000 deaths. For someone in that 80 plus category that has chosen not to vaccinate, what advice would you have?
Yeah, I would urge them to consider, why it is that they don't want to get vaccinated and if they would consider moving forward with it as they have proven to be safe. I think when you're in that age category, just being very honest with yourself of the risk if you would get a COVID infection, and not just for yourself, also for hopefully a spouse that you may be with and your family members as well.
We've all learned lessons during the pandemic. I'm wondering if you can share with us some of the lessons learned from your perspective.
Yeah, two things come to mind. One is always remember that you made the best decision with what you knew at the time. So I think as we look back at the last year, so many guidelines have changed, recommendations have changed, and that can seem confusing. And then being very open-minded to being adaptable and change your mind as more information becomes available. Secondly, I think, this has been a very divisive year. So I think it's so important that we listen to others to try to understand their point of view and give grace to others as well to live through this how they best feel comfortable with. Because in the end, what we want is united families, united communities as we hopefully come through and beyond this pandemic.
Thank you so much for your time today, Dr. Post.
Sure, I appreciate the opportunity. So thank you.
And Dr. Post describes herd immunity as a vaccination rate between 60 and 80%. For more information on receiving your vaccination, go to avera.org. We'll be right back.
Dakota.